Now let's take a look at scatter and align SOP. So let's create an geometry node and dive inside. And for this example, I'm going to create an a grass blade. So for that, let's create an a line SOP and bring up its parameter, and let's set its length to 2 units. Okay, and let's add an a sweep SOP, and here onto the surface shape, let's change this to ribbon. So here we have the ribbon. So let's check apply scale along curve, and let's scale the upper side to be lower value to create an a more pointier grass blade. And let's change the interpolation to B spline to have a smoother interpolation. And for the first point, let's change this to B spline as well. And in the middle, let's add another point. Let's bring this point down and the first point down as well. And as you can see, at the middle, the scale is not working. And that is because if I enable the smooth wire shaded, as you can see, we don't have the height segments. So for that, let's go into the line. So here, as you can see on the line, we only have 2 points. So the sweep SOP use these points to add an a height segments. So here onto the line, let's increase the number of points. Okay, so now as you can see, by increasing the line number of points, I'm adding the height segments. Okay, so let's go back and let me hide the point display, and let's create a very basic grass blade. Let's lower the base scale down, and let's lower the tip scale, something like that. Maybe let's remove this point. Okay, so let's add a bend deform to bend our grass blade. So press enter on the bend node to enable its manipulator. So the capture axis is not correct. So here onto the capture direction, let's add the y axis 1 and 0 out the z axis. And now we have the correct direction to bend our grass. Let's move the bend deformer up by changing the capture origin. Let's move it up, maybe there. Okay. And now let's create a circle. And let's change this to ZX to sit on the floor. And let's use the scatter and align SOP. So the scatter and align SOP is the modified version of the scatter SOP. This one. So the scatter and align SOP has some features. So when scatter and align SOP scatter the points onto the geometry. So let me change the point count method. It's set to by size. Let's change this to by density. Let's increase the density. So here, as you can see, we have some points. And let's increase the coverage area to 1 to fully cover our circle. So the scatter and align SOP, when it scatter the points onto the geometry, it is creating some attributes. So if we middle click, you see we have the N, so it is creating the normal, and the orient, so orient is an a 4 float, which means it's an a quaternion, and it's adding an a P scale and an a tag. So let's add an a copy to point. So these are grass blade, and these are our points. Set the display flag to copy to points. So here, as you can see, the scale is not correct. So go into the scatter and align onto the attribute. Let's uncheck the radius attribute, p-scale attribute. We don't need that. Okay, so the grass blade or blades are pointing on the wrong direction, and that is because if we set the display flag onto the circle, as you can see, the circle is facing on the downward. So let's add a reverse node to reverse the direction, facing direction of the circle. Okay, and now let's set the display flag onto the copied points. Now as you can see, our grass blades are pointing correctly. So let's go into the scatter and align. So here we have the rotation around normal. So let's change the max angle to 360, so which means they are allowed to rotate randomly from 0 to 360 degrees. And let's enable the max cone angle to add a spreading effect. Okay, and let's increase the density to a higher value, and let's uncheck the back face tinting. So by clicking on this button, tint back facing polygons. Okay, and now let's randomize the scale of these grass. So let's create an attribute randomize, and let's connect that. And the attribute randomize is randomizing the CD, which means the color attribute. So let's change this to P scale. And the P scale only has one value, so let's change the dimension to 1 and the distribution method to exponential. Okay, so now the scale is huge. So let's lower the global scale down. Okay, or maybe let's decrease it even further and go into the scatter and align, and let's increase our density. Okay, something like that. Okay, let's create a grid. Set the display flag to the grid and press enter to access its manipulator, and let's scale the grid down onto the y-axis. Okay, and now let's connect our grid into the scatter and align. So let's remove the circle, we don't need that. So here we have the grid, and now if we set the display flag onto the copied points, now as you can see, we are making the grass onto the grid. Okay, so here onto the scatter and align, let's go on to the point generation, and let's decrease the relax iteration to 0. And now if we set the display flag, so if we have enabled the relax iteration, here as you can see, the grass is spreading evenly across the grid, and I don't want that. So let's make the relax iteration to 0. And here onto the scatter and align, let's check the density attribute, and let's click on this brush icon to create a density attribute. So now we are on the attribute paint tool. So let's increase the brush size. For increasing the brush size, the shortcut is the control shift and press and hold the left mouse button and drag. So control shift and press and hold the left mouse button to drag to increase the brush radius, like so. And let's paint it across in this direction, and also on this direction as well. Let's add another stroke to create a more dense space. Okay, now let's go back to our camera view tool. So here we have created an NA path. Okay, so let me organize the node. So when we click this icon, it will created an NA attribute paint sub, and after that it created an NA density attribute and initializes it to 0, and then we are painting, we're using the attribute paint sub to paint our density attribute. Okay, now let's add rocks into this path. So here onto the grid, let's create a scatter and align sub, and here let's change the point method to density, and let's increase the coverage area, and let's increase the density scale, and go into the point generation, let's lower the relax iteration to 0, and let's create a basic rock model. So let's create a sphere and change the primitive type to polygons, and let's increase the frequency to add more divisions, and let's add a mountain sub. And let's change the noise type from simplex to whirly cellular F1. Okay, so now it's starting to more look like a rock. Let me change this to smooth shaded. And let's add another mountain to add another noise on top of that. So the method is set to add, which is correct. And let's lower the amplitude down to maybe 0.1 so that we have a little bit of bumps. Okay, so now let's organize these node, and let's add a copy to point sub to copy our rocks onto these points. So set the display flag onto the copy to points. So here onto the scatter and align, go into the attribute, and let's uncheck the pscale attribute, we don't need that. So let's create a attribute randomize, and let's connect that. And here let's randomize our pscale, and the dimension is 1. And here onto the scatter and align, let's go into the orientation, and let's change the max angle to 360 degrees, or maybe let's lower the density count by decreasing the density value. And let's add a spread by changing the max random cone angle. So let's increase that. Okay, something like that. Now let's merge our rocks with the grass. So let's create a merge node. Let's connect these grass with these rocks. Set the display flag onto the merge. And now as you can see, we are creating the scattering the rocks and the grass as well. Or maybe let's go back onto the line, and let's decrease its length to 1.5. And let's go into the sweep sub, and let's adjust the RAM parameters to create a more thinner grass. So that's basically the scatter and align sub. So here we have the round to multiple of, so which mean we are constraining the angles in by this value. So for to explain this option, let me create another grid and set the display flag onto the grid, and let's use the scatter and align SOP. Connect that, and here let's change the coverage to 1, change this to by density, let's increase the density, and let's create an a line SOP, and let's create an a copy to points. Now let's change this direction Z to 1 and Y to 0. Okay, and here onto the scatter and align, let's uncheck the P scale attribute, we don't need that. And here onto the orientation, here we have the min and max angle, so let's increase it to 360 degrees. And let's check the round multiple. So we can say whenever we are rotating over these points, they are allowed to take 90 degrees turn. Okay, so here as you can see, now our lines are rotated and they are exactly taking the 90 degree turns. So let's create a polywire after the copy to points up. And let's uncheck the UV visualization, and let's increase the wire radius and also the divisions to create a more smoother tube shape. Okay, so here as you can see, we are creating some sort of piping network. Let's decrease the density and let's increase the length. Okay, so that's the scatter and align SOP. Okay.